What's going on, guys? The Inhuman Beatdown. I'm back with more Fate Extra. Last time we did some level grinding to prepare for this. Today is the elimination battle. I trust that your preparations went smoothly. I turn toward the voice coming from behind me. He wears the clothes of a priest, which in the end only makes his snide tongue more jarring. Come to the first floor when you're ready. You can do something trifling like stop by the commissary if needed. Apparently finished, he opens the door and lets himself out. In preparation for the elimination battle, I should go to the chapel in the commissary. Or I could go to my personal room and sort out my information on the enemy's servant. And then, once that's in order, I'll go to where Kotomine is. Or I could do none of that and just say, fuck it. But that would be incredibly stupid. It is incredibly quiet. Okay, so there was something I forgot to do for the last video, but it wasn't really anything of great importance. It's merely information in the library on what is called the Faceless King. And I unfortunately don't remember what it was off the top of my head to basically say what it was. But we will learn it when we get all the information from Archer. Anyways, first things first, we need to have an alteration of soul. So close to structural mastery. But we did get something, and I don't remember what it is. Endurance rank. Oh, that's it. Well. That was boring. We have to go to our private room to get all of our information together. Right, our private room is on the second floor. Alright. It appears that you've taken down over 150 enemy programs. Although I normally recommend against fighting unless necessary. But as you're an inexperienced master, it's probably better to train in preparation for future battles. When you hit another milestone, I'll be sure to congratulate you again. Yay! Okay. Organize my information. Alright, let's review the information we have. Dan Blackmore. Oh, so good. Our opponent this time is a veteran soldier. Since I could never hope to make up decades of experience in a week, he's clearly got the advantage. Hold on a second. Okay. God, I don't know what it is about, like, early morning recording, but my voice always sounds like shit. I'm the inferior master, but when it comes to servants, his servant's class is... same as mine. It has to be Archer. That day in the arena, the servant fired a poison arrow at me. That kind of precise marksmanship was enough to tell me the enemy's class is Archer. It's also clear that said shot severed some kind of bond between master and servant. Dan forbid his servant to use his bow to fire poison arrows. That bow is his noble phantasm called... The name of that noble phantasm that Dan forbid his servant from using was... Was it necessary to say that twice? It was the U-Bow. The name of the servant's unrearing bow is the U-Bow. After Archer wielded it in the prep period, Dan utilized a command seal to disable its further use, telling him to fight fairly. Fighting face-to-face with honor and pride. Seeing as how Archer fought so differently in life, of course he doesn't get his master's values. The girl who helped me deduce that the skygazing beauty from the third floor, Ronnie. With the remains of the archer's arrow, she showed me the forest he held dear. The name of that forest was Sherwood Forest. Of course, it can only be one character. Right, it was Sherwood Forest, and there was only one legendary soul who was active there. Robin Hood. There's zero doubt as to the enemy archer's true name. Even with his true name, and taking into account the discord between master and servant, can I win? Our servants are pretty evenly matched, so if I can step up my game as a master... Alright, so now we know. Shocker, it was Robin Hood, as if the telltale signs weren't there to tell you. Speaking of which, I might as well have a look at this, because I said I didn't get a chance to look at it. Okay, it won't show up until I just kill him outright. Alright, well, let's head to the first floor. Wait. Right, almost forgot. Okay, good. I need the aromatic wood, because as he does rely on poison, I'm gonna need that to cure Archer when he gets poisoned. You will now enter the Colosseum and confront the opposing master. Are you ready? Remember, the only way to leave the Colosseum is to win. If you are ready, I will open the gate. I am ready. The way to the Colosseum is now open, young master. I wish you the best of luck and hope that you will return. Remember, it's kill or be killed. First trigger, second trigger. And the door is now open. But now everyone knows why I was giving the archer a British accent. Oh god, great. More tearing out my throat. Someone's got their serious face on over there. This is going to be so much fun. Huh? What's the point of talking to someone who's about to jump into their grave? Although I'm about ready to chew my arm off to get away from Grumpy here. The guy doesn't even fart without a purpose. I've given up trying to make small talk with him. Hey, enemy master. Why don't you try talking to Grumple Steelskin over here? Why do you fight?
There is no why in war. Once one enters the battlefield, they only fight to achieve their objective. A soldier does not need, no, cannot have a reason to fight. That is how things were when I was a soldier. Although my life has changed much since that time, I've never needed a why.
Don't you hate it when you're right? Like I said, the guy's a steel trap. Thanks for trying to pry him open.
The master's a stone wall, and the servant's a chatterbox who hardly seems like a legendary soul. We'd have been in trouble if the master and servant had been the other way around.
I wish my master stows straight-laced that an atypical legendary soul like me gets tied up in knots. I'll let you in on a little secret. Not all of us legendary souls were noble in life. That would be boring. Oh, and on that note, careful you don't get nailed from behind. Again.
The end justifies the means, huh? What a coincidence. I used to have crosshair blinders on, too. And my master is different this time. I will be full of doubt unless I fight fair and square.
What's this domestic strife I'm sensing over there? You don't care for surprise attacks, master? How far is too far? No foul play? No dirty tricks? Depends. That's the spirit. Clever person can turn anything into a weapon. This is gonna be a good fight.
Don't get carried away, Archer.
You call that getting carried away, master?
You're plundering our enemies for entertainment right before the battle. Yes, that is excessive.
Ding! Correct! You don't like it? Then go put on a helmet to match that armor and drown out the sound. But I want to talk to our enemies. Why don't you listen in? Learn what kids these days are into. As if you've got any more, ancient. They'd have to put you in a museum.
Your poorly phrased advice is duly noted, but mutual understanding will come on the battlefield.
Ha ha! You have no idea how to have fun. Elvis killing, 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 a guy's gotta unwind. A bowstring that's wound too tight snaps, isn't that right?
I have nothing against having fun.
Right! Life's hella hard and then you die. You don't enjoy yourself, then you'll just die miserably. Miserable, whatever.
Will you never gain the proper attitude to fight?
Lighten up, Master. Things would be so much easier for us if you just accepted life has funny parts. I go whoosh on that undefended back of yours. That's how an archer should fight. I have to be nimble on my feet. Chivalry and ideology are all stiff and would just slow me down.
Listen, Archer, you will fight as I direct.
Not again. Fine, fine, I get it. Your wish is my command. That's my master for you. Can't keep his chivalry in his pants even with a kid like you around. Ha! Penis jokes! I just wish he understood that not everyone can take pride in their lives.
Oh, thank God, we're finally done talking. I don't know how much longer I could have kept going like that.
A sudden rumbling snaps me out of the spell my opponent's words had put on me. We're at the battlefield. The time to fight a warrior of unparalleled determination has come.
Let's go, Archer. The time has come to embrace the battlefield once again. All will be settled here, Archer.
That's the spirit. Thank God I'll never have to see this guy's ugly mug again. Now that we have to say goodbye, I'm getting all teary. How about I fire an arrow for every tear I weep?
To keep as mementos? No, thanks. I'll just return your tacky little gifts. Besides,
There we go, I got something stuck in my throat.
And besides, I doubt you can try in the first place. You're as twisted as the roots of your beloved you.
Excuse me, look who's talking. If I'm twisted, you're a damn set of intestines.
Yeah. Let me give you some advice, Archer to Archer. A little bit of class goes a long way.
Give me a break. You're twisted and wretched, so what do you want me to say? That you're a lace dolly? Dolly? Whatever.
Something tells me we wouldn't make good friends.
Well, obviously, you're a miserable, pretentious ass. Tell me, how deep do you bury your feelings?
Oh boy, lucky me. Getting a probing question from a numbskull in return for my own. Let's end this. King of May, you've discarded his pride out of pride. Rescue you from your desperate life by killing you.
Bring it on. Are you ready, Master? I've got an arrow with that jerk's name on it.
It's time for a rumble. Archer versus Archer. It's time for a death battle. Live or die by the sword.
All right, with our Matrix level of 3, we can now see his shit. Let's see, I don't have anything to stun him, so I'm gonna have to take this shot for free projection. And then I'll weaken him. Alright. Okay, good, he guarded the first attack. Which works perfectly for me. Ball of thorns. Am I right? Actually. There we go. I'd be a fool not to take advantage of that. Raises accuracy of projection when using guard. Pass, thanks. Knew it! Guard on the first- oh shit! Right, now I'm poisoned. Which isn't too bad. I can just get rid of that poison on my next turn. Let's see. I could use a remedy. I'll use a remedy as to not have to waste my own power. I'll hit him with weaken again. There we go. Weaken him again. And now unleash devastating attacks. Well, almost devastating. Alright, now for sure I have to heal him. Otherwise, I will die. There we go. Shit, another poisoned arrow. Not bad, but I unfortunately got three on you, so now it's time to face ultimate devastation. Now I think he'll try to use his, noble phantasm. Or not. Gotta heal this turn, and then I'll use an item to cure his poison later. Guard. Break his guard. Faceless King? I don't know what that does. Oh, it makes him invisible. Lovely. Great. Now he's healing himself. Oh boy. Now comes the time when I have to go all out. Oh, right, I can't use fatigue because I don't have another pre-projection. Okay, that's why it's been failing this entire time. I just gotta heal Archer and pray. Because here comes his noble phantasm. And now just lay into him with a volley of Red Hound weakened shots. Really? He's gonna do it again? Well. Here's nothing. And I do mean nothing. another holy bowl of supplication, which I will guard. And there we go. Archer goes down with an arrow to the face.
An arrow for an arrow.
That was close. I was afraid I was going to lose that one. One second. There we go. We deal the enemy a finishing blow. It feels like I'm watching in slow motion as Archer's chest is impaled. Dan Blackmore looks dazed. He's staring at my archer as if my servant is some divine being. Crazy. How did we lose? My master has more ability and more determination than you. So how? And this is goodbye.
No. Archer, it seems I still lacked experience. I doubted myself too greatly in this tournament. It seems having a reason to fight is not the same as truly believing in that reason. I never doubted my desire to be a warrior, but that life has given me regrets. I wanted the Holy Grail to bring back my late wife. What a silly delusion. My whole life I praised myself for giving up my individual feelings and aspirations like a good soldier. Only at the very end did I dare to have my own goals and decide to abandon military life. I can't believe I was trying to fight as just a man. It was foolish of me to pit my pride as a knight against my feelings as a person. So foolish. I just wanted to get back what I had lost before the end. But I wonder which one I wished for, my late wife or the person I was before I became a soldier.
The elderly knight falls into silence. Both he and his servants start to disintegrate. And so does my voice.
But I'm surprised in you. When you unleashed your final attack, you had no doubt in yourself. Even though you can't describe what it is yet, there must be something that gives you a purpose. My wish, a wish to bring back the dead, was nothing to boast about. Though your trials are many, keep living, young one. Your struggles will steal your determination. Now, I apologize that you have to see me like this, but I am at peace in my defeat. Because for the first time, I am the ground from which a youth with a bright future might grow.
His final smile was beaming. Dan Blackmore's face was no longer stern, but kind and grandfatherly.
I'm sorry, Master. I knew I wasn't cut out for a fair fight. You needed someone better than a charlatan like me. I'm so sorry. Another servant wouldn't have failed you like this.
No, I'm the one to blame, Archer. Restricting your actions was selfish and damaging to your dignity.
A bit late for that now, Master. You have no idea the torment you've been putting me through. Why are you apologizing anyway? You're making me sound like a moron here. Why do you care about me? Whether we win or lose, I still vanish at the end. I mean, I did have a wish of my own. I was more interested in having a good time. Gotta tell you, it's been rather boring to fight for you, Master.
There's something else to apologize to you for. A warrior's pride must have held no value to you.
As long as I don't have to do it every day, it's a decent change of pace. Boring as it's been, playing knight was a healthy thing for me to try, you know? Well, although I was never given a chance, I've always wanted to try being a badass knight.
Dan's archer looks down as if embarrassment. He mumbles under his breath as if he doesn't want us to hear.
So really, don't apologize. We had a good run. There's nothing to feel ashamed about.
Jeez, I didn't even think I'd be able to pull off a single battle in this stupid tournament.
In life, I had everything I wanted. Wealth, fame, friendship, success. But fair fight was the one thing I never had. So it's okay. I finally did something I was never able to do.
Like he said, it was the end. Moments later, he vanished. He looked at peace. He lived his life in the shadows, protecting his village without acknowledgement. In his final moments, it seemed that he had found a way to get beyond the bitterness he felt.
I'm sorry. Thank you, Archer. Vala, could I trouble you to listen to the dying words of an old man? From here on out, no matter what enemy you may encounter or who you may have to defeat, feel it, think about it, process it, accept your doubts, but don't be crippled by them. Above all, accept the consequences of your actions and turn all you learn and feel into strength. If you wait until the end to think, you'll end up with regrets. And if possible, I'd like you to get meaning from your battles. Through combat, find the reason you fight, and the reason you can't lose. Find your answers.
I love how he kept moving backwards, but the screen never technically moved at all.
It's your responsibility to have the answers when you survive this war. Do you understand, Rising Star? Don't forget. Finally, I'll be able to see her again. It's been too long. And
don't you forget about me. Don't you... Okay.
He whispers a woman's name. It is spoken in a hopeful tone. With his answer warming his heart, Dan Blackmore disappears.
Another master has vanished. But you don't seem as shaken as after the first round. Either you mentally prepared for this fight, or simply have become used to battle. It's nice to see. No matter what has happened, you are no better or worse than anyone else in this Holy Grail war. Don't let every little thing shake you. Exhibit some of the composure that Shinji didn't. Maybe it wasn't all intentional, but he treated the rules of this war as if they were below him. A serious lapse in judgment. Thank goodness you aren't that arrogant. Those truly strong wish neither to die nor kill. In other words, they are humane.
As soon as we return, Archer goes mouthing off. Is this really how a servant acts? But the shock from the first round is indeed gone. It could be that I have acclimated it, but...
About Dan Blackmore, did you learn anything from your fight with him?
Yes?
I see. Well, I suppose it isn't so easy to. Not even that old soldier could avoid battle. That's human nature for you. Show me your true feelings in the fight to come.
The next battle. Right. There's a third round, and then a fourth. And so on. I'm still kind of lost. But if that's the path before me, then I owe it to the lives lost so far to keep fighting. Right or wrong, that's one way to think about things.
Well, that was a very interesting fight. A
And now we know all there is to know about Robin of Hood. Cool. And I suppose that's all there is to this. Now we may slumber and wait for the next round to come. Who will be my next opponent? Find out next time! Until then, if you liked this video, be sure to give it a like and share it with all your friends. And if you want to stay up to date with all of my latest content, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, guys, I'll catch you all later. Hasta!